Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch, interact and also learn. Your tutor today is Mr. Wanyoike, an agriculture teacher. I will be taking you in agriculture lesson 6. And it deals with the livestock production 3, and the subtopic is services in livestock. And to the lesson objective, by the end of this lesson, you'll be able to explain the various methods used in servicing livestock. The first one method is natural mating method. In natural mating method, you can see there is a bull here and also there is a cow. In natural method, the penis is used to insert the sperm or the semen containing sperm into the female reproductive system directly. Then we have, what are the advantages? Advantage number one, it is accurate. You can see that there is nowhere you are going to collect the semen, you are not going to collect the ova, but the two are deposited at the body temperature of the animal, and therefore it is very accurate. It is approximate about 99% accuracy. Then we have less labor barriers. You will not be involved as a farmer. A farmer is not involved in checking for the heat sign. Why? Because that is the work of the bull, and therefore the bull is very, very professional when it comes to detecting for the heat sign in a cow. Then we have used even when the signs are not easily detectable. As I have said, that the bull is a master in detecting the heat sign. Then we have the disadvantages of natural mating method, and the first one is it will encourage inbreeding, and therefore during inbreeding you might pass undesirable characteristic from one animal from the parent to their offspring, or you can pass the inbreeding diseases. The breeding diseases, for example, the vaginitis and brucellosis are the common breeding diseases which are normally transmitted, and therefore through natural mating method, such diseases may be transmitted to the young ones. Then we have injuring small female. In natural mating method, you find that a bull may be very, very heavy, and therefore if it is mated with a very small cow, it might end up breaking the small cow. Then we have wastage of semen. Remember, in one ejaculation, the bull normally releases millions of sperms, and therefore, and only one sperm is actually required for fertilization to take place, and therefore it leads to wastage of semen and sperm. Then it is very expensive. Why is it expensive? Because the farmer needs an extra piece of land to grow the pastures for raising the bull, and therefore that is an extra expenditure. Then we have, it is cumbersome. Whenever you want to use the natural mating method, you must transfer the bull to where the cow is, and therefore it also makes the process very, very tiresome and cumbersome. Then we go to the second method of servicing animals, and the second one is artificial insemination. In artificial insemination, the bull is normally brought to a teaser cow. Then that is, a teaser cow is a cow on heat, and therefore when the bull is about to insert the penis into the vagina, the natural vagina of the teaser cow, the penis is grasped and directed to an artificial manufactured vagina where the semen is collected. Then what are the advantages of artificial insemination? Serves many cows. It means that sperms from one superior bull can be used to serve many, many cows, and therefore transmitting high qualities to the resulting offspring. Then we have control in breeding diseases and also controlled breeding. It is a good method for controlling because there is no mating. Then no injury of small animals. As I have said, there is no bull mounting on the cow, and therefore the small cow will be very, very safe. Then no expenses of maintaining the bull. Yes, you don't require a bull so that you can practice this artificial insemination. You can just buy it from where it is supposed to be bought from, or from those people who normally supply the semen. Then we have a convenient for small-scale farmers, because small-scale farmers, they will not need to keep a bull, and therefore it becomes very, very convenient. Then semen can be stored. Yes, once the semen has been released by the bull, it can be stored in the test tube waiting for the recipient cow or a cow on heat. Then eliminate the dangerous bull. Yes, the characteristic of dangerous bull is eliminated, because in AI service you cannot collect a semen from dangerous bull, but only from those bulls which have a good temperament. Then we have used as a research tool. Yeah, in AI service, some semens are collected from the bull with an aim of doing a research in order to get a proven sire. Then we have the disadvantages. And the disadvantages of AI service, the first one, spreading of harmful trait. Undesirable characteristic can be transmitted from one superior bull to many, many animals. Then we have required skilled labor or a trained or trained personnel. Yes, a person like a veterinary is required in order to carry out these procedures and practices. Then we have low chances of conception, because the sperm might have died long time ago in case of poor storage. Then we have rebarriers than natural mating method. Yes, the farmer must look for the heat sign, because the bull is not a viable. It is not used in this method. Then the third one is embryo transplant. And in embryo transplant, it involves harvesting of ova from one superior cow, and also fertilizing the ovum using the collected semen from the superior bull, and therefore the embryo will be formed as a result of the two, the semen and the ova being put into a test tube, and fertilization will take place to form the zygote, and the zygote will develop into an embryo. Then the embryo can be stored waiting for the recipient cow. Stimulate milk production, that is another one. Then the other one is spreading good quality from one superior female. The cows in the whole village will acquire desirable characteristic. Then we have easy to transfer to transport embryo. Yes, than the whole bull. Remember, to transport a bull you require a pickup, you require a lorry, but to transport an embryo, it can be inserted in a briefcase where we have several test tube and transported using briefcase containing the cooling apparatus. Then we have embryo can be stored for long period for waiting for the recipient cow. We have come to the end of today's lesson, and I'm going to give you assignment. The first question, state any three methods of fur servicing in livestock. The second one, highlight any five advantages of artificial insemination. For reference, you can refer from Secondary Agriculture Student Book 3, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, if you'd like to clarify something from us, you can reach us at LMTV using the following addresses. You can use the SMS using the number which is well displayed. You can use the YouTube, you can use the Facebook, and finally you can use the Twitter at LMTV_KE. Thank you for joining me in this lesson. Goodbye.